I really think that this is more than just moving to BTRFS. This is the start of something great. This is how we actually make progress. Not long ago, it was proposed in Fedora that the BTRFS file system, also known as BTRFS, ButterFS, BTreeFS, all in all, that stands for BTree file system, it was proposed to be the default file system for Fedora, starting with Fedora 33. Now, Fedora 33 is not out yet, but it's in development and progress is underway. After some testing and a whole bunch of testing days and feedback from companies like Facebook and individuals in the community, from developers to simple users alike, it was decided that they would go ahead with this change and set BTRFS as the default file system for Fedora 33. This would replace ext4 as the default file system. I think this is absolutely genius, and there's a few reasons why. This isn't just because I like a ButterFS or BTreeFS. This is because the features that it provides and the standards that it sets are really critical. In my opinion, ext4 should not be the default. For any of you guys who have been using Linux for a while or are fairly familiar with it, you'll probably know that ext4 is almost always the default file system for Linux, for Ubuntu, it was a default for Fedora, and with some exceptions, like OpenSUSE using BTRFS as their default, it's pretty much standard. PopOS, Linux Mint, Solus, and there's good reason for it. ext4 is a fine file system, and it's rather quick, and it's easy to recover from when things don't go super well. But it doesn't have any of the advanced features that are actually just normal today, and shouldn't be considered advanced features, but should be standard. This is where BTRFS comes in. Now, it's a native file system for Linux, just like ext4 is, and it's actually built in a way that's meant to surpass ext4 as a successor rather than just an entirely different file system. You can build an ext4 file system into a BTree file system and actually migrate to it. So it's very clear that it's the next step in the process. But why is it so important that we move to something like BTRFS? For starters, BTRFS is a copy-on-write file system. Now, that in particular isn't necessarily important, but what it enables are features like snapshotting, which can be done on a per file or a per operation basis. So you can have a snapshot of your entire file system or certain parts of your file system, which you can later roll back to. Now, some people will ask why this is important for normal users or general users. And the reason this is important for those users is because when things break, they can actually undo the things that caused those breakages or just snap back to a previous point in history when that wasn't an issue. By default, this change in Fedora is only just going to be setting the default file system. This isn't really something that's going to immediately change the scene. But it does set the standard. If you look at operating systems like macOS, you have snapshotting abilities built into it now. It's a standard feature, and I'm willing to bet that most people who are using macOS and set up their backups don't actually understand and have to fiddle around with the file system itself. They're just able to reap the benefits that this technology gives them. And that's exactly what moving to something like BTRFS can enable for Linux users. This will facilitate the improvement of features that can enable backup solutions like snapshotting, not only just for the whole file system, but maybe for user settings as well as system settings, being able to roll back things independently. This is a step in the right direction because even Windows has things like shadow copy now. It's very clear that this isn't just an advanced user feature, right? We want these kinds of things to be normal. We want users to be able to roll back to things after things break without hassle. It's 2020. We've had this kind of technology around for well over a decade. It's not like we can't actually implement it now reliably. On top of that, it also supports something called compression. Now, compression, for all intents and purposes, essentially allows you to reduce the amount of space items on disk take by using various algorithms to shorten the length of them and then reprocess them later to fill in the blanks. And there are different methods that BTRFS can use to compress data on disk. And what's great about it is that this can be done in a way that doesn't really impact performance on a level that's noticeable to the user. Now, granted, there will always be some slight hit in terms of compression, but this compression can be so efficient that you won't even notice it when you're using it. And that's great, because this can actually save you disk space without really changing anything about the experience. Less disk space used for the same amount of stuff you're doing? Fantastic. That's just means you have more space to work with. Especially with, you know, some laptops not coming with tons of disk space. Some of them come with like 32 or 64 gigabytes of storage, which can leave you in a tight bunch. And on top of this, on top of the ability to have snapshots, on top of compression abilities, you've also got encryption options, which is probably a more advanced feature, but can still be very useful, and to have it supported on a file system level is fantastic. So this all sounds fantastic to me, and apparently it sounds fantastic to plenty of other people as well, which is why these features have been developed so heavily for over a decade now. But what exactly is so genius about Fedora doing this? And granted, I'm going to give credit to OpenSUSE here for actually going in on BTRFS and really working on it, having it as their default for so long now, where others were skeptical and didn't move forward with it. They've got snapshotting enabled by default. That's just what they've been doing. They've proven that this can work. Now, I'd argue that Ubuntu is definitely has the most large user base. Their range of user types is probably by far the most diverse. Fedora doing this is another drop in the bucket. This is another supporter of a more advanced but user beneficial file system as the default. And I think that moves like this and moves like what Ubuntu is doing with ZFS, which has snapshotting abilities as well, is promoting the presentation of features that are useful for users without making it difficult to actually use. So once Fedora has something like BTRFS in there as the default, this opens the door for systems like, you know, backup applications to be developed specifically for these functions to enable more user-friendly and flexible recovery solutions for any kind of user, whether it be simple users who just want to use a GUI tool, or advanced users who can always fall back to the terminal. These kinds of things should be normal, and we see it in systems like macOS and Windows, clearly proving that it is. So this move from Fedora is not only exciting because they're going in on a more advanced, more capable, and more functional file system, it also means that we are opening the door to more advanced features that can help plenty of users in the future. And I think that's really cool. I really think that this is more than just moving to BTRFS. This is the start of something great. This is how we actually make progress, by implementing the underlying technology that can make these, from a user level, basic features actually possible. You facilitate the development of the tools that the users can use to utilize it. And from there, anything is possible. And if we can see it get to the point where this is normal, we might even see things built into, let's say, GNOME that can actually handle this out of the box. Imagine not needing to install a separate utility to do your snapshots or backups or recovery. Imagine if that was built into the operating system and into your desktop environment from the very start. That's the goal. That's the dream. That's exactly what we should be striving to achieve. Otherwise, well, we're just hemorrhaging users. It's so refreshing to see projects like Fedora take a step forward here and work to make that happen. And I think that is super cool.